Today, let's build an application. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. And today, we will see the working of our application, AI Fitness Trainer, that will accurately monitor our squats, analyze the data, and offer real-time feedback. To develop such an app, we will leverage MediaPipe's deep learning-based human pose estimation solution. MediaPipe Pose is a ML solution for body pose tracking, inferring 33 3D landmarks. Learn more about human pose estimation with MediaPipe in a detailed course, OpenCV for beginners. The pipeline consists of two-step detection and tracking. Using a detector, the pipeline first locates the person. The tracker then predicts all the pose landmarks. Let's input a sample image and check what the landmarks look like. Using the MediaPipe Pose solution, we create the pose object. Then we infer over an image using the function process and get the following output after drawing the landmarks. There are 33 blaze pose landmarks. Each landmark has the X, Y, and Z coordinate. We will be using the shoulder, hips, knees, and ankle landmarks to calculate the different states of a squat. To be more accurate, we will calculate the angle between these lines and the vertical. The formula to calculate the angle between two lines is given by this. A proper squat involves maintaining a slightly lean back, 90-degree angle on the knees, and ensuring that the knees do not cross over the toes. This becomes our logic. A slightly leaned back, adequate depth, and knee alignment. We assume that the camera is positioned on the side and not head-on. You can try out the AI Fitness Trainer web app as well. Link in description. We will be observing 5 test cases, and accordingly, the application will provide feedback. First, if the back falls below a threshold, for instance 20 degrees, the app says bend forward. And if it extends too forward, say 45 degrees, the app says bend backwards. Similarly, if the knee angle is between 50 degree and 80 degree, we get feedback to lower your hips. And if it goes beyond 95 degrees, we hear the feedback squat too deep. And the last test case, if the knee falls beyond the toe. Depending on the threshold angle ranges, the app can be targeted towards beginners or advanced users. Moreover, it can also keep a count of correct or incorrect squats. When the user is standing, they are in state 1. As they start squatting, they transition to state 2. This is when the app starts recording the squat. As the squat goes deeper, it transitions to state 3. But the person needs to be in the correct squat range. If they go too deep or not deep enough, it is counted as an incorrect squat. Now coming back to a standing position, they go through state 2. This is when the app stops recording the squat. If the sequence of the states recorded were S2, S3, S2, the correct counter is incremented by 1. For any other sequences, the incorrect counter is incremented by 1. So that's how we created the AI Fitness Trainer. Check the link in description to try out the web app for yourself. You can also check out the blog post on AI Fitness Trainer. If you like this video, why don't you check out YOLO V7 Pose versus MediaPipe comparison? Do comment on what you would like to see next, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Until next time.